Hello and welcome to the Daily Roundup. I am Sumedha.
And I am Prashant. And here are the major stories for the day.
Post-poll violence in major parts of the country, and CPIM cadre were attacked in Tripura, and a bomb was also thrown at an ex-MP's house in Kerala. Mob lynching incidents have been reported from Madhya Pradesh and Gujarat. Surat fire exposes holes in safety measures. In international news, Trump to bypass Congress and supply weapons to Saudi Arabia. Today in the Daily Roundup, we focus on the post-poll violence across the country in the aftermath of the victory of the BJP. Some of the worst instances of violence have taken place in the state of Tripura, where at least one person has died and many have been injured. There has been a sustained attack on the cadre of the Communist Party of India Marxist. Reports say that the attack on the CPIM workers by BJP supporters began during the counting and have continued unabated. Dozens of offices of the CPIM have been ransacked and have been taken over by the right-wing forces. In another instance in Kerala, the house of MB Rajesh, the former MP from Palakkad, was attacked on Friday. Police sources said that the group of Congress workers are believed to be responsible for the incident. Rajesh, a two-time MP from the constituency and the LDF candidate in the election, was not at home when the attack took place. Investigations are continuing into the attack. West Bengal has also witnessed violence after the elections as clashes broke out between the members of the ruling Trinamool Congress and the BJP. A number of incidents of vandalization of houses capturing the TMC party offices were also reported. Some of the most serious confrontations took place in Bankura and Cooch Behar. A Trinamool Congress party office was attacked at Naihati and several motorcycles were also set afire. In a shocking incident in Madhya Pradesh Sioni, self-proclaimed cow vigilantes allegedly thrashed three Muslims, including a woman, over suspicions that they were carrying beef. The victim said that they were forced to shout Jai Shri Ram. A video of the incident is also circulating on social media and has gone viral, in which the accused hold the victims to a tree one by one and thrash them with sticks. The police has registered a case and has arrested one person and is on search for the other accused as well. In another incident, a mob of about 200 to 300 upper caste people had allegedly attacked the house of a Dalit couple in Mahuvat village in Padra Taluka of Vadodara in Gujarat. This was after the man, Praveen Makwana, allegedly put up a Facebook post suggesting that the government was not permitting the village temple to be used for the wedding ceremonies of Dalits. Following the attack on their house, Praveen's wife has also filed a case with the Vadu police, who registered an FIR against 11 people and a mob of about 200 to 300 people for attacking their house and pelting stones. However, the police have also booked Praveen for allegedly promoting enmity between different groups. For our third story, we're focusing on Surat in Gujarat, where at least 20 people were killed and several were injured in a major fire that broke out at a coaching center of the Takshashila Institute. Most of the victims of this tragedy were teenagers who were attending the classes. Some of the students reportedly died after inhaling smoke, while many others died while jumping out of the building to escape the blaze. Preliminary investigations have shown that the Takshashila complex had no firefighting equipment. The incident also raises serious questions on how such tragedies continue to happen. The Surat fire was the third such incident in the past 6 months in Gujarat. Previous fires in Surat and Ahmedabad have caused two deaths. Despite announcing inquiries into the incidents, the government has failed to institute measures to prevent the operation of coaching centers in buildings with no safety standards. The latest fire shows that the government has not learned any lessons from the past incidents. Moving on to the international section.
In our international news, we look at the United States of America, where President Donald Trump has decided to go ahead with an $8 billion arms deal to Saudi Arabia, despite opposition from the Houses of Congress. The US president has decided to use an obscure section of the Arms Control Act, which says that the Senate cannot disapprove of arms supply deals if the national emergency is in place. Now, this national emergency Trump is referring to is what he calls a threat from Iran. Of course, it must be remembered that the rising of tensions in the region is primarily due to the fact that the US has imposed sanctions on Iran and has also moved an aircraft carrier and bombers to the region. Trump also recently announced that 1,500 US troops would also be sent to the region. Experts, as well as members of Congress, are worried that these weapons that are being supplied to Saudi Arabia will be used for bombing Yemen. The Saudi-led coalition, which is also supported by the UAE and the US, has caused a massive humanitarian crisis in Yemen by conducting hundreds of bombing raids. Thousands have died due to these raids, and millions are on the verge of famine. The UN has called this the worst humanitarian crisis. Opposition to the arms deal also broke out in Congress after the murder of journalist Jamal Khashoggi at the Saudi consulate in Istanbul last year. The incident was allegedly the responsibility of Saudi agents, and Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman was believed to have been responsible for this. That's all we have in the international section.
And with this, that's all that we have for you today on this episode of the Daily Roundup. To follow these stories and many more, log on to our website www.newsclick.in, subscribe to our channel on YouTube, follow us on Facebook as well as Twitter. Thank you for watching.